Queensland Premier Anastasia Palaszczuk has launched a public disaster recovery appeal with $2.1 million from the state government. The appeal will direct donations to selected charities to help Queenslanders impacted by the floods. Meanwhile, the clean-up continues for communities in Queensland and New South Wales, even as the Weather Bureau warns of severe storms, putting them at risk once more.
Well, chefs Pip Sumbak and Wal Foster live in the Northern Rivers. They've been coordinating a mammoth effort to get more than 10,000 hot meals out to people who need them most. They're joining us now, Pip and Wal. Phenomenal effort, obviously. How did this all come about?
Well, guys, we're not even sure of that now. As just two chefs, I cook over fire. Wal makes ice cream. And we thought we'd just make a curry and help a few people in need. And it quickly escalated from a crowd fund of $500 to what it is now. And we were able to mobilise our amazing community here and create today maybe, I don't know, 20,000 meals going out.
Wow. Each,
yeah, plus.
Are you surprised that it's fallen to people like you to do this in this way?
Yes.
Yes.
We're not trained for this. As we said, we're chefs. And I think this needs military action. I've never seen anything like this. And suddenly we're at the front of, I don't know how many restaurants now, we've lost count, and how many people are volunteering every ounce of energy to give 20,000 plus meals distributed through boats, helicopters, every effort we can get to places that still 4 days, 5 days, I don't even know what date is, are still flooded. Even reports like at Corify, there's bull sharks circling places where people are on the roofs. And
they haven't seen food in 4 days, and we're the ones fielding calls.
It sounds like an extraordinary effort by everyone. Pip, food is such a staple of life, but the idea that people haven't eaten for days, I can only imagine what sort of reactions are happening when people have that food handed to them. What stories have you heard?
Well, Lisa, food provides hope. So we've had people come back to us saying people have been in tears when that food it's given to them. There's elderly trapped inside houses that haven't seen food for 4 days. And forgive me, Lisa, Wal and I have been working around the clock, and we're probably a bit emotional, but also very overcome and excited that we've been able to mobilise a beautiful community. But, yeah, we're overwhelmed that people are still trapped and we're the ones that are trying to get food to them.
Guys, we did hear that there was quite a lag between the flooding happening, people being left in remote locations without any kind of help. Do you know how long it took before help really arrived, how many days it was?
Up until half an hour ago, we're still getting reports of people being trapped.
Calling directly to our number, Lisa, to our phones.
Right now, our phones are going hot.
We have private helicopters flying to communities that haven't received food. We just need to see action, guys. We can't do this forever. And we need help. We really need help.
The
Northern Rivers community have banded together. We've done what we can, but we're spent.
Pip and Wal, congratulations on everything, and our love to all of you there. Thanks for talking to us tonight.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks so much for having us, guys. See you later.
And we know so many of you do want to help. If you want to donate to help Pip and Wal continue to feed the Northern Rivers communities, you can get details of their GoFundMe page. It's on our website right now.